The Starship Avalon carries 258 crew members and 5,000 passengers under the protection of a shield which will protect the ship from asteroid collisions while it is traveling to its destination on autopilot driving mode. It's on its way to the colony world of Homestead 2 from Earth, a journey that lasts 120 years. Unfortunately, Avalon meets a big asteroid that hit through its shield and goes into the ship, causing many interior damages including fusion reactor damage and hibernation pod failures. The ship AI system fixes many problems by itself, except for one sleeping pod, in which Jim, a mechanical engineer, is hibernating, but accidentally awakened. A digital instructor appears on the screen in front of him, saying he will soon arrive at Homestead 2. Jim is excited a lot by that. But not long after, Jim notices that he is the only one awake. He then follows the computer instructions, and goes to the service center and the bridge sector, hoping to find someone for help, but no crew member is found. Jim feels afraid, for he is completely alone on an isolated starship. What worse is, according to the digital tour system on the observatory, this is just the 30th year of this 120-year-long trip. Shaken by that, he plans to get help from Earth, but it will take 19 years for his message to get to Earth, and 55 years to receive a reply. Feeling disappointed and hopeless, Jim wanders in the ship and discovers a living man in a bar which delights him for a few seconds before he realizes the man is a robot named Arthur. After a quick drink and talk with Arthur, Jim tries to fix his hibernation pod but ends up failing. He almost gets locked and suffocated inside. After many unsuccessful attempts and inspiration from Arthur, Jim decides to enjoy himself in this large ship for the rest of the time. He breaks into a luxury suite, takes various delicious food, and enjoys himself in the entertainment and sports sections. It seems like he's the luckiest man with all his favorites, but a partner to keep him away from the increasing endless loneliness and depression. He finds a viewing deck section one day, where the passengers can go out of the ship in a spacesuit and see the whole deep space. He jumps into the immense space after he disengaged his magnetic boots. Embraced by the quiet and boundless universe, he feels so insignificant. A drop of tear slips down his cheek, for nothing makes him more lonely than floating in the unknown space. He tries to put an end to his miserable life after coming back in, but too afraid and falls over while running away from the viewing section. When he gets up, he notices a beautiful woman, Aurora, hibernating in her pod, which makes Jim can't help but fall in love with her instantly. In the following days, after checking all her video files and private information, he knows that Aurora is a writer. The more Jim digs about Aurora, the more he wants to meet the real her and gain her love, so an evil thought pops into his head that he should awake her. He can't stop talking about his evil thought with Arthur, the only one who can speak to him. He tries so hard to convince himself to forget Aurora. Battling with himself for a long time, Jim finally decides to wake her up. He feels so frightened as well as guilty watching Aurora waking up slowly, so he runs back to his room trying to calm himself down. However, he can't hold his feelings any longer and pretends to bump into Aurora. Aurora is shocked after Jim explains that she's accidentally awakened 89 years early due to some unknown technical mistakes. In fear, she tries many ways to make her back to hibernation, but fails every time. So she tries to adapt to the non-ideal situation and make friends with Jim, who is a total stranger to her. Through more conversations, Jim learns that Aurora has a round-trip ticket, for she plans to live on Homestead 2 only for a year and goes back to the future Earth 250 years later, so as to make her the best writer, with her unique story and experience. But Aurora now has to accept the reality, and starts to try different things with Jim on the ship, such as movie theater, high-end restaurant, basketball game, and dancing game. After a while, Jim asks Aurora out for a date and takes her to the viewing section, where they both put spacesuits on and float onto the endless space. The ultimate romance offered by Jim changes Aurora's opinions towards him. Aurora then falls in love with the romantic guy. One day, while leaving Aurora at the bar, Jim goes to get the ring he makes for Aurora as he plans to propose to her on her birthday. When he comes back, however, he finds Aurora turns completely different towards him, for that Arthur tells her that it is Jim who woke her up because he's so lonely all by himself on the ship. She storms away, refusing any contact with him anymore. Jim falls into guilt and wants to do something to win her love back. While the two are busy with their matters, a system failure occurs, but the AI system can't repair itself anymore. Jim plants a tree in the middle of the Grand Concourse, which impresses Aurora a lot. Soon they notice more system failures in different parts of the ship, before they heard a broadcast from the deck chief, who is suddenly awakened. The chief takes the two to the bridge and finds that the ship data display is broken, so all the three have to collect data manually. They agree on fixing the ship together tomorrow. At night, Aurora gets trapped in a giant water ball while swimming in the pool. Everything starts floating due to the gravity system failure. Fortunately, it's fixed by the ship AI system quickly. Jim and Aurora go to find the chief, who explains that according to the computer system, continuous problems have been occurring since 2 years ago and it is hard to find where to start the repairing process. However, the chief falls on the floor. The two put him in an autodock and discover that many of his organs are damaged due to a system failure that happened to his hibernation pod. The chief gives his bracelet to Jim before he dies, so Jim can access the authorized sections to fix the ship. A red alert is on, while Jim and Aurora are running to the main engineering section, in which they see an asteroid has hit through many cabinets, leaving a long trace that leads them to the source of the damage. There they see the fusion reactor control system is broken. With that fixed, they notice that the exhaust fan of the reactor doesn't work properly. However, it can only be fixed from outside. Without any choice, Jim goes out into space and manages to keep the fan gate open, so as to let the trapped heat out. After the heat is exhausted, the computer system reboots, and everything soon works normally. Unluckily, the high temperature breaks Jim's spacesuit and melts the tether that attaches Jim to the ship, causing him to float into space with no way to come back. Jim slowly loses his consciousness in the broken suit and sends his apology to Aurora in his last breath. Aurora then jumps out of the ship in a fully functioned suit, and pulls the unconscious Jim back before putting him in an autodock. Jim recovers later and tells Aurora that the autodock can put her in hibernation again. Aurora doesn't take her last chance to go back to hibernate. Instead, she stays and accepts Jim's love back. 88 years later, the crews wake up on schedule, shortly before arrival at Homestead 2. They discover that the Grand Concourse has changed into a sweet home with a huge tree, much vegetation, and birds, as well as a wonderful story that Aurora writes about their journey that she and Jim ever experienced. Check out other movie recap videos right here. Smash the like button, subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss upcoming movie recap videos. And until next time, have a good day.